the same party, with the same party leader, with this president of the United States, who had no problem at all interfering with the election of a prime minister in another country. Now they're wringing their hands. And let me tell you something. In the case of Obama and his thugs, there's fingerprints all over this stuff. Absolutely. Should he have been impeached for that? Did the Democrats jump up and down over that? Did our Praetorian Guard media jump up and down over that? When we know, as a matter of fact, that Obama and his surrogates, through this group One Voice, tried to topple Netanyahu, tried to elect his opponents? Well, I think it's worth going down memory lane just briefly. And I'm sure all you liberal Democrats out there are going to be sitting on the edge of your seat wanting to hear every bit of this. Because it's not about Putin, who I happen to despise, by the way, despite the bizarre love affair some pseudo-conservatives have with him. But it's about our president, who I also happen to despise. The One Voice campaign, this is in the Jerusalem Post, but it was everywhere, was funded in part by their State Department grant. That is, an NGO used U.S. tax dollars in an anti-Netanyahu election campaign, the Senate finds. The Senate Subcommittee on Investigations published a report finding that One Voice, an international nonprofit organization once funded by the State Department, actively campaigned against Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu during Israel's 2015 parliamentary elections. Their campaign was funded in part by their State Department grant, the report found. One Voice entered the headlines in 2015 after absorbing V15, an Israeli group that actively campaigned against the Netanyahu government. 1 year earlier, One Voice had successfully secured a $300,000 State Department grant. V15 founder Nimrod, I like that name, and he is, Nimrod Dweck, or is it Dreck, responded by highlighting the conclusion of the report that State Department funds allocated to One Voice were not used during the period of V15's campaign. The campaign was funded solely by private individuals, Israelis and Jews in Israel and abroad, he said. One Voice defended itself, noting in a statement the Senate report found the group in full compliance with the terms of its grants. Aaron Shaviv, the Likud strategist in 2015 election, said the report provided that his party faced more than the Zionist Union in the race, and he goes on. Notably, the investigation was signed off by members of both parties, unusual for this type of report. Subcommittee Chairman Robert Portman, member Claire McCaskill, drew different conclusions. Of course they did. The Democrats are, in essence, mafioso. But how do you like that? Oh, well, what should we do about that? No, nothing. So Obama goes after the Prime Minister of Israel through a few of his surrogate thugs that run this nonprofit organization. The State Department granted $300,000 to this umbrella organization, and the money becomes fungible in one pocket, out the other. And the whole purpose was for our government, run by our president, your president, not mine actually, but Obama, to topple the Netanyahu government and install a left-wing government more to his liking. Now this is a fact, ladies and gentlemen. This is indisputable. We don't even need an investigation. It's an indisputable fact that Obama played a big role in the election in another country. And he's done this before, too. When he does his little stupid press conferences, well, they're not little, but they are stupid, where he goes on and on and on, suggesting I support this candidate, Merkel would be very good, you know, I'm against Brexit. He does this all the time. But this was different. This time it was different. This time there was a direct effort by our government, by Obama and his cronies at the State Department, and his surrogate cronies with these nonprofit front groups, to topple the government of another country, an ally, a democracy, and the same party that defended him, and the same party that encouraged him, and the same party that wanted the leftists to win, is now chasing shadows.